grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the name of God, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us confess our sins to Almighty God. Eternal God, in whom we live and move and have our being, Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you anointed your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and with power to bring the good news of your kingdom. Anoint your church with the same Holy Spirit, that we who share in his suffering and his victory may bear witness to the gospel of salvation through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty? The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Revelation. Grace to you and peace from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and freed us from our sins by his blood, and made us to be a kingdom, priests serving his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Look, he is coming with the clouds. Every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. And on his account, all the tribes of the earth will wail. So it is to be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. The eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to say to them, "Today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." The Gospel of Christ.
O God, take our lips and speak through them. Take our minds and think through them. Take our hearts and fill them with love for you, In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Hand-me-downs. I grew up in a family where hand-me-downs was a thing. Whether it was gloves or hats, mittens, coats, sweaters, pants, shirts, anything that could be handed down, including shoes and boots, were handed down. My mother was very practical. She bought new clothes, but always too big. Pants were too long, sweaters were oversized, shirts were too big. And she'd say, "Don't worry, you'll grow into them." My mother always hemmed new pants, and then she lowered them and hemmed them again, and then lowered them and hemmed them again, and then they hemmed to the back, to the end where you could not hem again, and then passed down. I wore jeans that had hem lines that you could count like rings on a stump. The clothes never really fit properly. If the waist was too big, then you tugged at the belt. If the shirt was too long, you tucked it in. If the shoes flopped because they didn't quite fit, you put Kleenex in the toes and you would just kind of grow into them. I realize now that it wasn't just clothes that we were handing down. There were other things that would come in the form of hand-me-downs. When I look at what we have in our home, I would say that almost all of the chairs, the tables, the side tables, the lamps, the plates, the silver, all of it has been handed down from a grandparent, a parent, an uncle, an aunt, a friend. Each piece saying something about a story and a connection with us. And it's not just material things that we hand down. It's the stories that we tell around our dining room table. It's the recipes that we use year after year after year to set the meal. It's the humor that we pass down. It's the stories of long ago and just yesterday. Certain teams in a hockey pool need to be adhered to. There are moments when we share our hurt, and we pass down our faults, but we also pass down our forgiveness, our grace, our hope, our musical talent, our athletic prowess, our intellect, our body shape. The face that we have gets passed down, DNA gets passed down. And often we don't know what passes down. It's not until somebody says, "By golly, you look more and more like your mother all the time." Or, "Don't you know you sound just like your father?" Or, "You walk just like your brothers." And it's when you look in the mirror for a long period of time and you look and you say, "Oh my goodness, I do look like my mother. How on earth did that happen?" Faith is a hand-me-down experience. It is handed down to us as pew dwellers. We are formed and shaped by liturgy, influenced by Sunday school teachers and choir directors and clergy, by matriarchs and patriarchs from one parish to the next. Being a part of a community or a parish is very much like being part of an extended family. A hallway bears all the pictures of previous rectors. Some churches have many and some very few. Old pictures of picnics and choirs and Sunday schools tell the elaborate story of the past that we're connected with. Choir gowns that are decades old hang in the cupboard ready to be used. Vestments from a previous rector or from an associate or an honorary that are ready to be used in the chancel party for this time round. From one generation to the next. But it's those little moments that get passed down as we tell the story and worship together as people of faith. Sometimes they're deeply personal. Sometimes it's just a word you remember from a sermon long ago, or a hymn that continues to move you to tears, or prayers that you experienced in the touch and the grace of the Holy Spirit, or a moment when you poured the chrism on a forehead and etched in a finger and sang the words, "You are Christ's own forever," or a moment of laying on hands at the altar rail, or joining hands for marriage, or standing by a bedside and offering last communion and last rites, or the moment when you walk down the aisle for the first time at the back of the parade to preside at the Eucharist, or saying the office in the morning. Every single one of those little moments dotted through time that fill a quiver and help us to quiver again, knowing that the part we play in this drama, as deacons, as priests, as bishops, as laity, compel us once again to remember that we are to proclaim good news, liberty to the captives, recite to the blind, to help the lame walk, and to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. One of the most precious things that clergy can hand down to other clergy are implements of ministry. Some of us have a stole or a chasuble or a cope or a communion set that another cleric who has been close to us has gifted to us. And as we wear them, we pray that we will grow into them as they did. One of the most precious for me is this pectoral cross. It was given to my father when he was consecrated bishop on September the 16th, 1990. And it was gifted to him from St. George's, St. Catharines, and the people of Christ Church Cathedral in Ottawa, people who shaped him in his ministry. And on the day of my consecration, he handed it down to me. Just enough room on the back, not much left, just simply to put three initials, AJA, Andrew John Asbill. What makes this cross even more significant for me is that it's the same design that you'll find at the top of the spire of St. George's Church in St. Catharines, my home parish, where I first had an inkling of God calling me to the priesthood. Full circle. And today we gather in this place on Tuesday in Holy Week, and it is the story of God's love for us that underpins everything that we do. And it is this week, more than any other week in our journey, that reminds us of the deep love that God has for us and for the whole of creation, and that compels us as clergy, especially this day, to come full circle and to reclaim our ordination vows, and to pledge again to walk with humility and with faith. Some of us are doing this tour for the 25th time as a cleric, 25 years of ordained ministry, 25 Holy Weeks. Some of us are doing it for the 50th time, 50 times through this liturgy of Holy Week. And we know that each year is different. The words may remain the same, but we are different. We bear different griefs, different sorrows, different hopes, different dreams, different aspirations, filling our quiver one by one each year with a deeper hope that God deepens with us as we go. A very dear friend of mine who's a cleric that I've served with for years, just retired, 40 years, I said to him, what are you going to do when you retire? He said this, I have been using my hands for ministry for 40 years. They have shaped me and I have shaped others. And God continues to shape me by using them. I can't give that up. May all of us, even in retirement, never lose that joy and that purpose that no matter what age or how imperfect we are or how broken we are, we'll be a blessing with God's love as we go. I can't think of a better, more beautiful group of clergy on the planet that serves and tills and cultivates the soil in this diocese than you. You are a deep and rich blessing to the church in small communities, large communities, spread across this diocese. The effects that you have had in the lives of people who dwell in the pews in your communities that are touched by your word, by your prayers, by your presence, makes the difference and saves lives. As we speak these words of recommitment today, listen to the voice next to you who speaks with you. Listen carefully to your own heart as God summons you, because this faith needs to be handed down. Amen. Let us confess the faith of our baptism as we say,
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead.
Fellow servants, at his Last Supper, our Lord Jesus Christ gave his disciples a new commandment, that they should love one another, and he prayed that they might be one. He gave them an everlasting sign of his own love in the sacrament of bread and wine. He consecrated himself to his Father's service to be the high priest of the new covenant. I invite you now to dedicate yourselves afresh to his service, as stewards of the mysteries of God and ministers of his grace. At your ordination, you accepted the yoke of Christ for love of the Lord and his church. Are you resolved to unite yourself more closely to Christ and to become more like him, joyfully sacrificing your own pleasures and ambitions to bring his peace and love to your brothers and sisters.
With the example of the Lord who washed his disciples' feet, will you be faithful in serving the needs of others and diligent in caring for those in need and trouble, in strengthening the faithful and in searching out the indifferent and the lost? My will, my God.
Will you fashion your life according to the pattern of Christ, that you may be a true pastor by word and example to the people among whom you serve?
By the help of God, I will. Will you work in partnership with all whom the Lord has given you and encourage all the baptized to grow as the royal priesthood of the new covenant? By the help of God, I will.
Will you be a faithful minister of the mysteries of God by leading the worship of his people with devotion and care, and by teaching the Christian faith with conviction and joy?
By the help of God, I will. Will you continue in the way of Christ, the head and shepherd of the Church of God, whose grace is sufficient to meet your need? By the help of God, I will.
Andrew, Rosilla, and Kevin are bishops. Will you be faithful to the promise you made at your consecration to uphold the truth of the gospel?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you promote unity, peace, and love among all Christian people, especially in this diocese, and be diligent in prayer and the reading of the Holy Scriptures?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you strive to become more like our Good Shepherd, the teacher and servant of all, and so to be an authentic sign of Christ's loving presence among us?
By the help of God, I will.
My brothers and sisters, pray for us, your bishops, priests, and deacons. Ask the Lord to bless us with the fullness of his love, that we may be faithful servants of Christ, our great high priest, serving the church with gifts that encourage and equip the people of God, and make Christ known in our generation.
Lord Jesus Christ, hear us and serve.
Almighty God, who has given us the will to undertake all these things, give us also the strength to perform them, that he may complete that work which he has begun in us, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Together, holding the space of silence between words, trusting in God, listening to obey God's will, let us pray for wholeness and healing, saying, God of love, hear our prayer. May we, as followers of Jesus, live from our faith in our work and in our rest with humility and kindness. God of love. For all the baptized, sharing in Christ's eternal priesthood, may we continue to seek and serve Christ in all persons. God of love. For deacons, priests, and bishops, that all may lead through generous listening and hospitality. God of love. May we acknowledge our faults and open ourselves to forgiveness, letting go of things that keep us bound and distant from contentment. God of love. May we endure the difficulties of change and learning with courage, patience, and a willingness to listen to wisdom in others. God of love. For leaders of villages and nations, for all persons of authority, that their lives may be marked by peace, service, equity, and integrity. God of love. For all who live with hurt and oppression, all who are disregarded and unheard, that their voice and their story may be given dignity, their distress healed, and for all who stand in the midst of human suffering, God of love. For all who suffer illness of mind, body, and spirit, and for all who care for them, may they know your peace in their pain, your strength in their weakness, and your comfort in their sadness. God of love. For all who have died, bless their journey of eternal peace, and for all who grieve, may they know you embrace them in compassion. God of love. In your presence we pray, loving God, leaning on your heart for all these concerns and those known only to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please be seated. It is now our joy to celebrate with those who are celebrating a significant moment in their lives in ministry, 25 years and 50 years. And we will be having Bishop Priscilla and Bishop Kevin to read those names. We'll invite you all to come up, and then we'll have a picture with Michael, and then we'll clap together. But if you break out in clapping because you can't help it, well, do that.
Silver Jubilee Stoles, 25 years. The Reverend Canon Hernan Astudillo. The Reverend Canon Jacqueline Boutillon. The Reverend Ray Dobson. The Reverend Canon Stephanie Douglas. The Reverend Helga Elliott. The Reverend Canon Maurice Francois. the Reverend Heather Gwynn Timothy. The Reverend Marilee Moore. The Reverend Dr. John Oakes. The Reverend Mary Pataki. The Reverend Canon Dr. Judy Paulson. The Reverend Dr. Peter Robinson. The Reverend Mary Ryback. The Reverend Karen Sandell. The Reverend Janet Seide. The Reverend Canon Nicholas Skinner.
Golden Jubilee.
Before we do that.
Oh yes, before we do that.
Michael, would you like to take a picture of the 25s?
You're going to do a picture of everybody?
The 25s.
Sure. Yeah. Just move in.
That's good. You can.
Golden Jubilee, 50 years, priested in 1974. The Reverend Fred Carson. The Reverend Donald Downer. The Reverend Robert Gorham. The Reverend Canon John Hill. The Reverend Michael Lee. The Reverend David Mulholland. The Reverend Canon Harold Nahabedian.
Stand. Beloved, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
God's peace. loving God, your Son was anointed by the Holy Spirit, not to be served, but to serve. Receive all we offer you this day, that we who are called to serve you in the world may be effective ministers of your healing love. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. For you anointed your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and with power. And you anoint us with the same Spirit in baptism, making us a holy people in the royal priesthood of the new covenant. Your apostles anointed the sick and healed them, and by your grace the ministry of healing continues in your church. For you sustain us with your presence, and drive away sickness of body and spirit, giving us new life and health, that we may serve you both now and forevermore. Therefore we praise you with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. We give you thanks to you, Lord our God, for the goodness and love you have made known to us in creation. In calling the Israelites to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all in the Word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In Jesus you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In Jesus you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, that this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we, made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. Send your Holy Spirit on this oil, that those who in faith and repentance receive this holy unction may be made whole, and that those who are sealed with chrism may share in the royal priesthood of Jesus Christ. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new, and bring us to that city of light where you dwell with all your children, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
As our Savior taught us, let us pray. We break this bread.
Communion in Christ's body once broken.
Let your church be the wheat which bears its fruit in dying.
If we have died with him, we shall live with him. If we hold firm, we shall reign with him.
The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
rest, and proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
The Maker of heaven and earth.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. May the God of mercy transform you by his grace, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain amongst you always.
Amen.
Followers of Jesus, inspired by the Holy Spirit, go and serve the world God loves. Thanks be to God.